in September 43 just started at the actor's studio, the Royal Actor's Studio in Copenhagen. He was happy about that, that was a dream that has come true. And but in the end of September, his father calls him and says, under no circumstances you can stay home. You must sleep with some acquaintance that we have, together with your sister, and wait for a signal to take the train up north. So he goes out to these acquaintances, and the day when the signal came, after some days, they take the train up north. In the train, they are there's a man who's making contact to them and tells them that you have to get off the train in a by called a little town called Rungsted. And they don't know him, but they do as he says. And in Rungsted, they are told to when it gets dark to go to the sea. And so they do, and here they meet with their parents and four other Jews who are waiting for escaping to Sweden. Someone has confined found a rowing boat, and that it has been difficult because in the beginning of October came regulation that all small boats have to be kilometers inside the countryside, so they were out at the coastline. But someone has brought up this rowing boat, and they are told that if they can go to an island in the middle of this Öresund, which is called Rhin, this is Swedish, so if they can reach that, they will be safe. The eight persons go down jetties to the little rowing boat, sits in that, and they just sit in the boat, and it starts to leak. The water comes in, and the one who has brought up this boat, he fixes something. They empty the boat for water, and he says, now it's okay. And then they have to pay 220 pounds each, and then they are ready to go to this island. No one of these eight people knows to sail a rowing boat, but this is their only chance. They have to do as good as they can. So they start rowing, and it's colder, and it becomes more windy, and they have been told that they have to look for two flashing lights at the island, so they know in which direction they have to go. But when it gets more windy, it starts raining, and they can't see the flashing lights, and the boat starts to leak again, and they have to empty the boat with water, and they are rowing and rowing the whole night, because next morning, 9 o'clock, they are still in the middle of the sea. Then comes a steamship passing by, and as it is on the ship, you have to help people who are at the sea. So they are taking about into this, on board this steamship, and they realize that it's Danish. And they tell us about their dangerous journey, and they ask if could they maybe take them to Sweden. They found out that they had been rowing a big row around the island the whole night. It would only take this steamship about maybe 20 minutes to go to Sweden. But the captain says, I'm not on the way to Sweden, I'm on the way to Aarhus. It's in Jutland. But his crew says, but can we then bring them to Aarhus? And he's just laughing, and he leaves them with no words. And 20 minutes later, an motorboat from Helsingør with the Gestapo is lying outside this steamship. And when Ralph's mother sees this, he takes from her bag a little bottle. It's with a kind of morphine and cognac. And they all have a little bottle. And they drink the contents if they want to take their own life. But it doesn't work immediately. So they are taken with the Gestapo to Helsingør, where they have to tell about their journey and how they got the boat and all these things. And they are quite busy for this. They've been drinking. But after that, they are bring it to the camp of Horsewald. And here, the Gestapo cleans them for the poison they've been drinking. And they are taken care of just so they will be ready on the 12th of October to be sent to Theresia. Mm-hmm.